a medical point of view. We know from a spiritual point of view some of the benefits, but this is going to be from a medical point of view. And then something that I'm calling fitness to fast. Who should fast? Who should be very careful and perhaps have medical clearance before they fast? Because we know there are some risks. We'll talk about what to do before the fast, what's done during the fast, and some guidelines for after the fast. And then we'll talk a little bit more directly about what we do in our Jain traditions and maybe some considerations for change based on what is known from the medical supervised experience of fasting. So for the purposes of a medically supervised fasting definition, we're going to say fasting is consuming water only. I know some people do chovia, but right now we're talking about water only fasting for a specific amount of time. And this is important, in an environment of complete rest. And what this leads to is the burning of mostly fat in the body. Now, how many people who fasted have gone to work while they fasted? A lot of us go to work. How many people who have fasted really maintain their social activity and their family responsibilities? A lot of people, right? So this is okay, but for the optimum health benefits, what's recommended is that you fast from not only food, but activity and responsibilities. Allow your body to truly rest. What is starvation? It's when a person has exhausted their nutritional reserves, so everything you have stored is gone, you've gone through it, and that then what happens is the structure and function of vital organs is harmed. So that's when muscles and organs start to get compromised. And that's generally not what we want to do, right? That's not the purpose of our fasts generally. There's another whole category with sadhakana, which is a different topic than we're discussing.